Good morning everyone and welcome to today's market commentary. So this is Nifty's daily time frame chart, and we can see that whatever the pattern we have marked yesterday in the market commentary session, that is broken in the yesterday's day end session itself. Only thing is the trend line which we drew that did not get broke yesterday day end session. Only today we had a gap up and price retraced exactly until this trend line and horizontal support, and now it seems to go up. So on daily time frame, bullishness seems to have been started on Nifty. So I'm removing this pattern now. So it might have given one more chance to participants to enter the rally. So it came down until yesterday's close. So yesterday's close was around 10,245, and today's low is also around somewhere there, around 10,240. So it gave one more chance to participants to enter the rally. So mostly the conclusion on Nifty on daily time frame is that the falling channel is now broken. So we have a gap up today, and this trend line resistance as well as this horizontal resistance, both of these will try to act as supports now. Even though Nifty falls down, these trend line resistance and trend line and this horizontal resistance, both of these must now convert into support zones, and they will definitely come to rescue of Nifty. So on daily time frame, this is the only thing visible here. Based on pivot points, we have already discussed that Nifty is trading above central pivot point, so it is already in bullish zone, and it is also trading above 20 period moving average. We consider 20 period moving average as short term trend decider. So short term trend is also showing bullishness in Nifty. So both the indicators are indicating bullishness in Nifty, and we also have the breakout of falling channel. So this is the conclusion on daily time frame. Now we already have our targets marked up here. So first, if someone wants to enter Nifty now, so the first target could be 10,345 to 10,360. And if Nifty manages to close above that, we can trail the price until 10,428 or 10,430. So even on early time frame, our inverse head and shoulders pattern got activated now. So the neckline is broken. So there seems to be no visible resistance on early time frame also until 10,345. So only if we can get a resistance in form of pivot points, we need to see, and even pivot points are also indicating no resistance as of now. So straight away, the target is 10,345. So our natural resistance is in confluence with pivot point R2. So this week, it would be tough for Nifty to break this 10,345 to 10,357 levels. If it can break this easily, then straight away the target can be 10,430. So on early time frame, even pivot points is also showing bullishness. So Bollinger Bands, it is trading near upper channel. Now, once the upper channel gets broken, there are chances that it might get extended in the same direction. So one such example could be here. When price closed above upper channel of Bollinger Band, it just went across at least until 100 points of movement was made after this Bollinger Band upper channel was broken. So even now we can expect the same thing, but only thing is this candle, the first 1 hour candle should close in green. So the today's open price is 10,274.6. So by 10:15, we need to achieve a price greater than today's opening price. So only Bollinger Bands is restricting Nifty as of now. If this candle turns out to be green, then we can get a rally up until 10,345. One needs to be cautious of this bearish divergence too. So if Nifty continues its rally, so this bearish divergence will get invalidated. But until this today's high, which is 10,275, until that gets broken, one needs to be cautious of this bearish divergence. So in intraday time frame, Nifty is bullish only if it closes above today's open price. So today's open price is 10,274.5. So if Nifty closes above this on 15 minute time frame, only then one needs to enter the bullish side. So you can see here, this is 10,274. The reason it faced the resistance, if you go to the left of the chart, there is resistance for around 1 hour or so. At the same price, all these candles, there was a supply zone here. So price fell and all of a sudden distribution took place here, and again new sellers entered the market. So this zone is very important, that is restricting the rise of Nifty as of now. So if today's opening price is broken on 15 minute time frame, even on 15 minute time frame, we can see the next resistance only at 10,324. So if 10,274 gets broken, we can see a rally until 10,324 today itself. So I'm repeating everything on 15 minute again. So story remains same on 15 minute. Only thing that needs to be observed is whether this 10,274 is going to act as resistance or not. Why is it acting as resistance? Because earlier we had a supply zone at 10,274. So once the price has reached the same zone, it is now acting as a strong resistance there. So once price closes above this 10,274, we are bullish on Nifty, and today itself we can see a movement at least until 10,324. Why 10,324? Because again on the left hand side we have a small supply zone. This is not as strong as this zone, but some sort of resistance can be faced at this zone, 10,324. Now if this gets broken, our target on hourly time frame, which is 10,345, will easily get meted. Now if Nifty finds resistance here, we also have this bearish divergence waiting for confirmation here. So all these things needs to be carefully seen. Now will Nifty be able to close above this 10,274, and will it form a reversal pattern? Now, when will this bearish divergence get activated? If Nifty closes below yesterday's close, if a 15 minute candle is found closing below 10,245, then we are again bearish on Nifty and our bearish divergence pattern will get activated. So the bearish divergence is because from this point, price made a new high and RSI made a lower high. But we are still in the process of making. We are not yet confirmed whether this pattern gets activated or not. if it will get activated only if Nifty closes below yesterday's close, which is 10,245, and this pattern will get invalidated if today's open price gets broken and if Nifty starts its rally on the bull side. So we have discussed intraday levels for bullishness and bearishness, and we are also awaiting confirmation for RSI bearish divergence. Now let's enable our pivot point for intraday, and even pivot point for intraday is also indicating the same. The resistance is at 10,276, just 2 rupees away from the opening price. So this is forming a very strong resistance zone for intraday now. Let's hope if it breaks the resistance zone and continues its rally on the upside. Now to the bearish side, one more point got added, that we have pivot point at today's opening price itself. So to be on bullish side, Nifty definitely have to break this opening price. Until then, we are not on bullish side. So Bollinger Bands here, this story is same. Already the channel got broken yesterday itself. Let's see how far it gets extended. It is already above the 20 period moving average, so it is in bullish zone. Now when price already broke this upper channel of Bollinger Band, how should you trade? You need to find a reversal candlestick pattern somewhere near the upper channel. So here you can see there is a bearish engulfing pattern, and here also the large red candle, it closed below this green candle. So already Bollinger Band upper channel got extended until here, and then we found a red candle which closed below the common price level of previous two candles. So we could see a bearish rally until here. Again, when price went here until Bollinger Band upper channel, again we saw a red candle closing below the opening price of prior green candle. So this is a sign of bearishness. When price breaks the upper channel of Bollinger Band, wait until a bearish candlestick pattern, two candlestick pattern or three candlestick pattern is seen. Only then enter the bearish side. So on 15 minute, this is the conclusion. So we have our levels marked on daily time frame, hourly time frame, and 15 minute time frame. Now let's move to our other index, Bank Nifty. Even in Bank Nifty, we have this head and shoulders getting broken in the yesterday's session itself. So today we have this neckline getting broken on Bank Nifty daily time frame, the inverse head and shoulders pattern. So this pattern got activated just today. Now today, where is the stiff resistance? It is at 24,594. Now this red candle is having the same high price, 24,588, and today's high is also 24,588.95. So the exact high prices we can see here. So this is the intermediate resistance being faced by Bank Nifty. So until and unless this 24,588 gets broken, Bank Nifty is not bullish. So once this gets broken, an easy 200 point rally can be seen in Bank Nifty on daily time frame. So the falling channel, it got broken, and inverse head and shoulder, that also got activated in Bank Nifty too. So a rally in Bank Nifty will also take Nifty upwards. Based on pivot points, it is already in bullish zone, trading above central pivot point. And even short-term moving average, that is 20-period moving average, is also indicating bullishness in Bank Nifty. Now, we can't say that it is difficult for Bank Nifty to break this resistance level. Only thing is, it is giving chance to market participants to enter at every stage. So this is not the final resistance which Bank Nifty is going to face. It might cross also. We shall see if it is having that capability in lower time frames. So on hourly time frame, we have a bearish divergence here on Bank Nifty too. So let me remove this support lines at the bottom. Again, once Bank Nifty comes there, we can mark them. So let me mark the bearish divergence now. Is not yet confirmed, but we are awaiting a confirmation here. Price made a higher high and RSI is now trading below the prior high. I'm just marking a horizontal line here. So RSI needs to cross this previous high to be on bullish side. So price already crossed its previous high. Now it's turn of RSI to cross the previous high. Once it crosses, then this bearish divergence gets invalidated. Why are we stressing on bearish divergence as of now? Because price is trading near prior resistance zone. So RSI divergence will have some sort of significance at this zone. So it is best to be careful at this point. Let it close above this resistance zone, today's high. And then you can be on the bull side. And on early time frame, we have this R1 coming up at 24,621. So this will have a greater significance. I'll tell you the reason why. So the R1 of this week and R1 of prior to prior week, both are in confluence. So that is one reason. And if you just move to the left of the chart, three candles here have taken support at the similar zone. So this zone is going to act as a good amount of resistance for Bank Nifty for this week. And that zone is from 24,594 to 24,621. So it's not going to be an easy rally for Bank Nifty on the upside. There are many resistances on intraday time frame, on hourly time frame, and so on. So it needs to overcome all these resistances on the top to continue its rally until 24,790 and above that 24,961. So let it close above this resistance zone on first hand, then enter the bullish side for around 100 or 150 points. And if it closes above this zone again, a 200 point move can be seen in Bank Nifty. So we have marked our resistance levels on daily time frame as well as hourly time frame. Now, if you see R1 on week on hourly time frame and R1 of intraday, both are at similar zone. So 24,600 is going to act as a strong resistance in Bank Nifty for today. It wouldn't be that easy for Bank Nifty to cross this level. And we already have this clear bearish divergence in Bank Nifty. Price making a higher high and RSI making a lower high. So this will definitely try to stop Bank Nifty from going up further. But if at all this previous high is reached, which is around 90, So then our RSI bearish divergence will also get invalidated. Only thing is we are awaiting for a confirmation. We are still in a bullish rally, but if at all there is a U-turn, then we'll enter on the bearish side. And even here also, the reason remains the same. This bearish divergence is seen at resistance zone, a very strong resistance zone. That is the reason we are stressing more on this bearish divergence. Now we are able to see this bearish divergence even on Nifty and as well as Bank Nifty. So today the rally won't be that easy as thought. So these are the levels for indices Nifty and Bank Nifty. Now Alok is asking about SBI and SAIL. Let's see them. So price is in a very tight congestion zone. Until and unless this 257.8 or 257.9 that gets broken, we cannot say that is bullish. We already had a bullish divergence on SBI and we got a confirmation too, but these resistance zones are stopping SBI from going up further. So this was the bullish divergence on SBI. So if you had entered at this price level, a closing price of this candle 246.5, so you could have waited. But as of now, if you want to take new positions, so it is not bullish until it closes above this 257.9. And even above that, we have many resistances here. So only short term profits can be booked in State Bank of India if you're entering now. Now SAIL is at a very good stage. Very clear bullish divergence was there prior. Got many confirmations too, and at present it is at a very crucial juncture. So this is the resistance on daily time frame, 76.36. Now if there is a close above that, straight away you can expect it to go until 79.32. now a rule while trading on bearish divergence or bullish divergence is that if you see bullish divergence, wait until all the prior resistance gets broken. So today we have a gap up and let's wait for a close above the prior resistance. Above that, we don't have any resistance on daily time frame. Around 3 rupees of movement can be easily seen if it gives a close above 76.35. until 79.35 you can see the movement. So wait until it closes above 76.35. It is also trading above central pivot point. That is a sign of bullishness. And even Bollinger bands are also saying the same, trading above the 20 period moving average. But this upper channel of Bollinger band is acting as resistance. If it closes above this high, then that should not be a problem. It might get extended on the upside also, but wait until this 76.35 gets broken. I think Rajiv, we have covered this Nifty 15 minute pivot point. Yes, this price is approaching the pivot point now. So we are bullish only if it closes above this pivot point, because it is matching with the resistance zone, prior resistance zone, as well as today's first candle open is equal to high price. So more number of things are on bearish side on 15 minute time frame. So we are aware of this. So let us wait until the opening price gets broken. So there's one more stock which I was seeing, PVR Cinemas. And by the time of starting this market commentary, it already gave a rally. Now, why are we interested in this? First of all, I need to go to line chart. Here we have a small bullish divergence. Price closed lower, whereas RSI closed on the upper side. And the next candle itself, the prior high of RSI got broken. So here is the next candle. I'm marking a horizontal line there. And let us switch back to candle chart now. So this was the bullish divergence seen. And next candle itself, there was a gap up opening and the value of RSI, it closed above the prior high. So that is first sign of bullishness and confirmation. Now again, there is a resistance in form of 1260 here. So this 1260 is a very strong resistance zone. Even this candle had the same price. Here this was the other candle. And that price acted as support for many candles prior. Now today in 15 minute time frame, if you can see, so let's see the other indicators also here. Pivot points, trading above central pivot point and Bollinger bands. The 20 period moving average is just now getting crossed over. So 15 minute, if you can see here, once there was a breakout here, 1260.5, that should be our buy price. And it went until 1281.95. At 22 points of move in just half an hour. So here we can formulate a trading strategy out of this. First, we need to go onto the daily time frame. See if there is any bullish or bearish divergence on candle as well as line chart. Once there is a divergence, that indicates that momentum is now going to lose in this particular stock. So there is a good momentum earlier that was a bearish momentum. Now once this bullish divergence was seen, so you should be cautious about taking new bearish positions here. And what this indicates is bullish divergence indicates that bearish momentum is getting its losing its strength now. And bullish momentum can start at any point of time. Now, first level of confirmation for us is the RSI value closing above prior high. And we have also waited until the resistance on daily time frame got broken on 15 minute time frame. So here on daily time frame, I marked my resistance level 1260. And then I went into 15 minute time frame. I entered at 1260. So I easily booked, one could have easily booked a profit until the high made today. So in order to determine the targets, what one should do is just go back to the left hand side of the chart and see what are the immediate resistances available. First resistance is 1271 and the second resistance was at 1280. So this is the high. So this candle's high is going to be my final target for today, which is exactly at 1280. This is the target zone. Even pivot points are also saying the same. R2 is exactly at that zone, 1280. Now, one more thing what you can do is you can scan for any candlestick pattern and then see now if a stock has been falling down. So check for any bullish candlestick pattern there. If you find any bullish candlestick pattern, check if there is any RSI bullish divergence and see if that area meets any prior support and let it break an intermediate resistance zone and then you can be on the bullish side for the rest of the month. Now this PVR cinemas is having a potential to reach until 1337 this month. Now how are we so sure? Let it get let the 1280 price gets broken. Now intermediate target is 1300. If it closes above 1300 also, then we can definitely see PVR cinemas going until 1335. Bullish divergence on daily time frame. RSI's previous top was also broken and the resistance also got broken on intraday time frame. Now to take long position in daily time frame, we are awaiting a break of this prior resistance, which is 1280. If 1280 gets broken, we can see stock going until 1305 rupees, because that is R1 of this month as well as the high made by this candle. Even if this gets broken, then finally we can wait PVR to go at least until 1335. So these are all the indices and stocks that we have seen today. Thank you all for joining today's market commentary.